Hello friends.
In this session, we will try to understand the code of Quicksort. So let us try to understand how exactly Quicksort works. If you're observing, there is an array X and the elements of this array are taken in the descending order 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Right? These are taken initially in the descending order so that you can understand the difference between best case and worst case complexity of the Quicksort. So here you can identify there are some elements. Those are pivot, that is first, last, and some values. So some values are assigned. I will remove those values so that we can do calculation. If you can observe, pivot is available at the initial state. We will map all these things in the code. And if you can observe, there is a recursive tree and there is a recursive stack. So all these things we are going to discuss. Let us take an overview of a code. If you're observing, there is a main. This main is present over here. There is a quick sort, right? So this quick sort is present over here. And it is going to take the number of elements. N is 5. So this line will take the number of elements. This particular for loop will enter those elements. And this quick sort is going to give a call to this particular function. This function, and this function indicates what it is having the pivot element. It is having a if control statement which starts over here and it's end at the last. Then these three lines are there. Then there is a while, and inside this while there are again two nested whiles. So the largest complexity is located over here, and after that there are again some sorting operations and there is a recursion present over here. So if you're observing, this recursion is going to divide this array into two subparts. So this is a brief overview of the code. Without spending time, let us discuss the content. So if you're observing n is equal to 5, we have taken this array and we have called this quicksort x 0 n minus 1. So what is the scenario? Let us observe here. x 0 and n minus 1. That is, we have called quicksort 0 to 4, right? After that, control will come to this one and this is a function. So first will become 0 and last will become 4, because here 0 is present and here n minus 1 is present. So at the beginning, first will become 0 and last will become 4. After that, it will check the condition first is less than last or not. So 0 is less than 4, that is valid. So it will execute these three lines. Pivot will become first element. So pivot will become first element, that is nothing but 0, right? First will become I and J will become last. First will become I. I will become first, that is 0. And J will become 4. Right? So these are the things. And after that, while loop will get executed. Right? So while I is less than J is the condition. I is what? I is 0 and J is 4. Right? Now next statement is, while X of I is less than or equal to X of pivot. X of I is x of 0 is less than x of pivot, less than equal to. So 5 is less than equal to 5. Is it valid? Yes. So in this context, what it is going to do, it is going to increment the I. Right? So I will become 1 now. Now I will become 1. So from here, I will be shifted over here. Right? Now again, control will come to this while. And again, it will check x of I is x of 1 is less than or equal to x of pivot. X of 1 is 4. 4 is less than or equal to pivot. So 4 is less than 5. That is okay. So in that context, again, it is going to increment I. So I will become 2. I will go to this 2. Because here is the condition. Right? Then I should be always less than last. So that is another condition. Again, x of 2. X of 2 is what? That is 3. 3 is less than or equal to 5. And this 2 is less than last. What is the last? 4. So 3 is less than 5. That's why I will become 3. I will go to this 3. So x of 3 is 2. So 2 is less than equal to 5. That is also valid. So it will increment I. I will become 4. So I will go to this 4. Right? And what is the condition? The condition is I must be less than last. Right? So if we are making this I is equal to 4. Now 4 is less than 4. This is not valid. That's why this particular while loop will be broken. and control will come to this while, right? And what is the condition? While x of j is greater than x of pivot, what is current x of j? J is at 4, so j is standing here. X of j, that is 1 is greater than pivot. Is it valid? This is not valid. 1 is not greater than 4. So if this is not valid, in that case this while loop is going to break here itself. Because x of j is what? X of j is 1 right now. 1 is greater than 5. This is not valid. Right? So this while loop will be broken and control will come out of this one. And what it is going to check? This if I is less than j, what is the current value of I? I is 4 and j is also 4. So this is not valid. So in that context, what is going to happen? Control will go back to this while. Are you getting? Because this if is a part of this while. So control will go back to this particular while, this while. And it will again check while I is less than j. Is it valid? I is less than j is not valid because I is also 4 and j is also 4. Right? So in this context, it will break this for loop also. And control will come to this particular line. T will become x of pivot. So pivot will be copied into T. So this 5 will be copied into this T. Right? And what will happen? X of j will be copied into x of pivot. What is x of j? X of j is x of 4, that is 1. 1 will be copied into this pivot. Right? So this 1 will be copied over here. And what is the next line? T will be copied into x of j. So T will be copied. T is what? 5. So this 5 will be copied over here. So this 5 will be copied over here. So if you are observing, 1 and 5 has been swapped and both of them have got their proper position. After this 3 lines, it will call quick sort once again. So it will be x first and j minus 1. Right? So this will give invocation to the next branch of the quick sort, that is x first and j minus 1. What is the current value of first? First is 0. So it will call quick sort x 0 j minus 1. What is the current value of j? J is 4. So it will call 0 to 3. Okay. So because of this particular movement, it will call 0 to 3. Right? So this is going to call this one. So in this context, we have got this particular element sorted. That means element 5 is sorted over here. We can say that, right? So this is first and j minus 1. Okay, I have taken this branch over here. This should be taken over here. 0 to 3. If you are observing, this is 0 to 3. And j plus 1 and last. So the next branch will be what? Quick sort x j plus 1 and last. J plus 1 is what? So here it is. J is 4 and the next branch will be 5, 4. So if you are observing here, x, j plus 1, j is what? 4. Here it will be 5 and 4. So now this one. So it will be this line. This is the right branch, j plus 1 and last. The last element is 4 as observed here. But at the beginning, who will get invoked? Not this one. This will get invoked. If you are observing 5 and 4, this will get broken over here itself. That means 5 has got its proper place. So we will get x 0 3. That will get copied over here. 0 3 will get copied over here. This is on the top of the stack. Now from here, control will again go back to this one. Quick sort x first and last. So first will become now 0 and last will become now 3. Last will become now 3. So first will become 0 and last will become 3. Because of this particular statement or because of this particular element, we have divided this array into two parts. The first one is 0 to 3 and the second one is 4 to 4. That means only one element, right? Now again the realignment will be done. If first is less than last, is it valid? Yes, first is 0, last is 3. We will execute these three statements. These are the initialization statements. First will be assigned to pivot. So first will be assigned to pivot. That means pivot will become 0. That is valid. Then first will become I. So here I will become 0. And last will become J. So what is last? Last is 3. So J will become 3. Right? So these three lines are executed. After that, there will be an execution of this while loop. This while will execute in this context. There are two nested whiles. There are two whiles inside this and one if. While I is less than J, is it valid? Yes, it is valid. I is 0, J is 3. Right? After that, X of I is less than or equal to X of pivot. Let us align these values. I will become 0 and J will become 3. Let us align these values. I will go over here. J will be at 3 and I will be over here. Right? While X of I is less than or equal to X of pivot. X of I is what? X of I is X of 0. That is 1 is less than or equal to 1. This is valid. Right? And I is less than or equal to last. This is also valid because 0 is less than 3. In that context, what we are going to do? We are going to increment the value of I. So I will become 1 over here. I will become 1 over here. Right? I will go to this particular one. Now again, check the condition. Again, this while loop will get executed. X of I is less than or equal to X of pivot. X of 1 is what? 4. 4 is less than or equal to pivot. Is it valid? This is not valid, right? Because here X of I should be less than or equal to X of pivot. So 4 is not less than pivot. That's why this particular while loop will be broken. Control will come to the next while. Now, while X of J is greater than X of pivot. X of J is what? This one. 2 is greater than pivot. Is it valid? Yes. So in that context, we are going to decrement the value of J. So J will become 2 and J will come over here. Again, check the condition. X of J is greater than X of pivot. So X of J is 3. 3 is greater than 1. This is also valid. Decrement J. J will become 1. Okay. And again, check the condition. X of J is 2. So J has become now 1. So X of 1, that is 4. 4 is greater than pivot. This is also valid. So in this case, what we are going to do? You are going to decrement J and J will go to this place. J will become the pivot element, right? Now what we are going to do? X of J is greater than X of pivot. So here it is not valid. 1 is greater than 1. So this is not valid. So it will, this while loop will be broken over here. Now what is the condition? Condition is if I is less than J. What is the current value of I? I is at 1 and J is 0. Now I should be less than J. In that context only this if will execute, right? So here it is not valid. That's why this will not execute. From here control will again go back to this while. And it will check while I is less than J. Is it valid here? I is less than J. This is also not valid. That's why this while will be broken. Now control will come to these three lines. And these three lines will do what? X of pivot will be copied into T. X of pivot is what? 1. 1 will be copied into T. Right? After that, X of J will be copied into X of pivot. X of J is what? X of 0. So this 1 will be copied itself inside this 1. So this is an override operation. Okay? And this T will be again copied into J. So T is what? 1. 1 will be again copied into J. J is at 0. So again, there will be one more override. So I hope you are getting. Okay? So this is the scenario. So these operation you need to understand properly. After these operations are done, then we will come to the next line and we'll call what? Quick sort X first and J minus 1. So it will call quick sort first. What is first? 0. And J minus 1. J is what? 0. So it will call quick sort first. First is what? 0. And J minus 1. J is what? 0. So 0 minus 1 is what? So that is minus 1. Minus 1 is what? This element. right? So this particular statement will be called, this is a recursion, and from here it will go with these two values. First is 0 and this one is minus 1. So 0 and minus 1 will be passed to this one. So first will become what? First will become 0 and last will become minus 1. Let us observe here. First will become 0 and last will become minus 1. And again, condition will be checked. First should be less than last. So first is less than last. Is it valid? Not valid. That's why what will happen? This if will not execute. Right? And this if will end over here. It will come back and it will go back to the quick sort. That means from here, look, this 0 minus 1 was pushed onto the stack. I will show it on the stack also. I forgot to show you. So this has been popped now and control has gone back to 03. So this 0 minus 1 was this branch. Now next branch will get executed. That is what? J plus 1 and last. So it will call the right hand side branch. J plus 1 and last. What is J right now? 0. 0 plus 1 is what? 1. And what is last? The last value is already available. That is 3 here. For this context, it is 3. Don't consider this value because here it is 3. So it will execute quick sort 1 to 3. 1, 2, and 3. So this will be pushed now onto the top of the stack. Now we will execute quick sort 1, 3. If you are observing, 1 and 5 are the elements who are sorted. Right? And remaining 3 elements are remaining to be sorted. So this is a quick sort. I will call quick sort X 1, 3. So from here, control will again jump to this one. So first will become 1 and last will become 3. And accordingly, values will be changed. First will become 1 and last will become 3. Right? First is 1 and last is 3. So these values are changed. Now, check the values once again. If first is less than last, this is valid. Now execute these three lines. Pivot will become first. So pivot will become 1. And first will become I and last will become J. First will become I. So I is 1 and last will become J. J will become 3. And arrange the values accordingly. So where I will stand, I will be there at 1. Pivot also will be there at 1 and J will be there at 3. I hope you are getting. So pivot is 1, I is 1 and J is 3. Okay. Now, again apply the conditions. There is a while loop. This while loop will start here and end over here. While I is less than J. Right? So 1 is less than 3. This is valid. Check the condition. X of I is less than equal to X of pivot. X of I is what? 4. 4 is less than equal to 4. Valid? Yes. So in this case, it will increment I. So I will become 2 now. Now I will become 2. Right? Again, come to this while loop. X of I is less than equal to X of pivot. X of I is what? So X of I is 3. 3 is less than equal to pivot. Just hold for a second. So this one will become X of I. X of I is what? X of I is standing right now here at 3, right? So 3 is less than equal to pivot, right? Is it valid? Yes, this is valid. So it will increment the I. I will become 3. Now again, increment the I, value of I will become 3. I will come over here. 2 is less than equal to 4 as per this condition. 2 is less than equal to 4. So in this context, what is going to happen? This is also valid. So it will increment I will become 4. Right? But this will be, I should be less than last, right? What is the current value of I? I is 3. I should not become greater than that. That's why this will be broken over here. So I will stand over here. Now, what is going to happen? So here, it will come to this particular while loop. X of J is greater than X of pivot. X of J is what? 2. This is greater than pivot. Is it valid? 2 is greater than 4, it is not valid. That's why this while loop will be broken here itself. If I is less than j, is it valid? I is not less than j, because value of I is 4, j is 3. Right? So this is not valid. So this if will not execute and this curly bracket will be over. Now it will come back to this while I is less than j. This is also not valid. That's why this while loop will be broken and control will come to this line and it will swap this. So it will do what? It will swap pivot with j if you are observing these three lines. So these three lines are going to swap pivot with j. So this pivot and j will get swapped. So 2 will come here and 4 will come here. Okay. Now after this, what is going to happen? Control will come to this line. Quick sort x first j minus 1. So what is first here? First is 1, right? So it is going to call this one. Right now we are over here, right? At 1, 3. So let us see what it is going to call. This is quick sort 1, 3, and this is So we'll take this value directly over here. Quick sort 1, 3. So it will call this one first and j minus 1. What is the current value of first? First is 1. Right? It will call quick sort first 1 and 2. So it will go to the left hand side. It will call 1 and 2. Because it is going to call the value that is j minus 1. So it is going to call first x 1 2. And from here, again 1 2 will be there onto the top of the stack. 1 2 will be there onto the top of the stack. And from here, with 1 and 2, the control will go over here. So 1 will become first and 2 will become last. I hope you are getting. 1 will become first and 2 will become last. So according to the previous step, we have sorted 4. Okay. And in this step, what we'll do? As we sorted 1, in this step, we will sort 2. There will be an override operation as we have seen before. And then we'll sort 3. If you are observing here itself, the array has been sorted. Okay. But the iterations will keep on happening. So it will sort quick sort 1, 2. Then it will give invocation to this one, 1, 0. And then it will give invocation to 2, 2. And then that will be sorted. And this way, all the elements will be pushed onto the top of the stack. So I will not go into the explanation of this one because from here, it will jump back. It will again execute the iterations as we have discussed before, right? And then it will execute the next line. And from that, as per the previous discussion, executions will happen. And finally, the array will be sorted. So here the array has been sorted. And this is the conclusion. Okay. I'm not explaining the next steps as you can try for the next steps. Okay. As we have seen before, you can try the remaining steps. Thank you.